true statement. So remember, yes, it's a true statement. For leukemia and lymphoma, we are following WHO. So at present, we are following WHO classification. So this point we should understand. At present, we are following WHO classification for leukemia and lymphoma. So leukemia and lymphoma. What is leukemia? What is lymphoma? This is another important concept. Leukemia, when these tumor cells are involving peripheral blood or bone marrow. So remember, when you will say it's a leukemia, when tumor cells are involving peripheral blood or bone marrow. So when tumor cells are involving peripheral blood or bone marrow, they are called as leukemia. When they are involving tissue and organs like lymph node, then we are saying that it is a lymphoma. When tumor cells are involving lymph nodes or tissue, that is known as lymphoma. So leukemia / lymphoma. So why I have written like this? This is another AIIMS question. AIIMS 2009, there was one option that leukemia may have lymphoma phase also. True or false? Leukemia may have lymphoma. True or false? So now you can see that this is a simple rule of metastasis. When tumor cells load are more in peripheral blood or bone marrow, peripheral blood or bone marrow, tumor cells are more, where they will go? Where they will migrate? When they are more here, they will migrate towards the lymph node. Do you follow me? When they are more, they will migrate towards the lymph node. On the other hand, if you look at the reverse, if tumor cells are more inside the lymph node or in organs, then simple rule, now they will move towards the peripheral blood. So either way, it is a true statement. Leukemia may have lymphoma and vice versa. So remember, this is a statement mentioned in AIIMS exam. Leukemia may have lymphoma. So this is a true statement. Leukemia may have lymphoma and vice versa. Its opposite is also true. So this is a true statement. Leukemia may have lymphoma or lymphoma may have leukemia. So either way, it is a correct statement. So here 2 points we have to understand. Anakif, WHO classification number one. Second point we have to understand is leukemia may have lymphoma or otherwise. So these are two important information. WHO classification says that we classify leukemia either as a Hodgkin's lymphoma or non-Hodgkin's lymphoma leukemia. So Hodgkin's and non-Hodgkin's. So they have divided them like this: Hodgkin's lymphoma and non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. So another question. In general, when we talk about lymphomas and leukemia, lymphoma. This was a question in DNB exam 2013. Previous year DNB exam, there was a question: in lymphomas, which lymph node is most commonly involved? Which lymph node is most commonly involved? They had not mentioned Hodgkin's or non-Hodgkin's. So remember, it is applicable for both of them, Hodgkin's as well as non-Hodgkin's, for both of them. Lymphoma, most common lymph node involved is cervical lymph node. So this is how Wintrobe says, in lymphoma, most common lymph node involved is cervical. If it is given in option, this was given, that will be the best answer. After that cervical, second most common is supraclavicular. So these are two groups of lymph nodes which are commonly involved in any lymphoma. Cervical is most common, and after that supraclavicular lymph node involvement. So here examiner will ask his question, ki which is a nodal disease? Nodal. Lymph node involvement is common in where? Which of the lymphoma? Non-Hodgkin's or Hodgkin's? So remember, Hodgkin's lymphoma is nodal. Lymph node involvement is common, whereas non-Hodgkin's are extra nodal. Question number two. This was the question in AIIMS exam. Stepwise involvement in a young patient. Stepwise involvement of lymph node in a young patient is a feature of Hodgkin's or non-Hodgkin's? Stepwise means orderly involvement. Orderly means first cervical, then axillary, mediastinum. So they are following one order. Contiguous or continuous chain of the lymph node will be involved. Whereas in case of NHL, it will be a random involvement. So remember, nodal involvement, and this is a stepwise or orderly involvement. Stepwise involvement or nodal involvement. Whereas these are extranodal, and if lymph nodes are involved also, then they are random involvement of the lymph node. So these are 2 points we have understood. Hodgkin's lymphoma is nodal and stepwise. Non-Hodgkin's is extranodal and random. But here another exception which examiner could ask you. Non-Hodgkin's lymphoma usually extranodal, except for two groups of lymph nodes where they are commonly affecting non-Hodgkin's lymphoma and rarely affected in case of Hodgkin's lymphoma. So these are two groups of lymph nodes. Number one is Waldeyer ring. So these are exceptions, Waldeyer ring. And number two is mesenteric lymph nodes. So these are two groups of the lymph nodes commonly involved. So these are two groups of lymph nodes commonly involved in NHL, not usually seen in case of Hodgkin's lymphoma. So this could be your future MCQ. Which lymph node is commonly involved by non-Hodgkin's lymphoma? Either it is a Waldeyer ring of the pharynx, or it is a case of mesenteric lymph node in abdominal areas. So this point we should remember. Final point about this Hodgkin's and non-Hodgkin's general differentiation. Non-Hodgkin's is usually aggressive and having poor prognosis. So they are having more aggressive, whereas Hodgkin's lymphoma is less aggressive and they are carrying good prognosis in general. So I will start from Hodgkin's lymphoma. So this is the one brief outline of lymphoma. So what we have understood, WHO classification we are following right now, and lymphoma may have leukemia or leukemia may have lymphoma. So this is a true statement. And most common lymph node involved in Hodgkin's lymphoma or non-Hodgkin's lymphoma or just lymphoma is cervical or supraclavicular lymph node. So first I will start from Hodgkin's lymphoma. Hodgkin's lymphoma, usually they are associated with Epstein-Barr virus. So remember what I am saying now, Hodgkin's lymphoma, usually they are associated with Epstein-Barr virus infection. Usually, I am not saying always, usually they are associated with Epstein-Barr virus infection. Epstein-Barr virus, they will infect which cell? We have discussed already, they will infect B cells. They will infect B cells. And what is receptor for Epstein-Barr virus? All India question and ANB question previous year. So what is this receptor present on B cell? It is called as CD21 receptor, also known as complement receptor 2. So this is another important MCQ. This was the question in DNB exam. Complement receptor 2 is present on B cells, which will combine with Epstein-Barr virus. On this combination, this B cell will be activated and transform into a neoplastic cell. This neoplastic cells will have a mirror-like nuclei. This neoplastic cell, see, this was a B cell. When they combine with Epstein-Barr virus, they will activate B cells. They will transform them into neoplastic cells. So now we are talking about neoplastic cell. And this neoplastic cells are having mirror-like nuclei. And this nuclei will be having prominent nucleoli. Because of this prominent nucleoli, remember, it is because of nucleoli they are also called as owl eye appearance. So owl eye appearance is given name to a which cell? What is this B cell known as? What is name of this neoplastic B cell? What is name of this neoplastic B cell? This is called as Reed-Sternberg cells. Reed-Sternberg cells. So this is called as Reed-Sternberg cells, which I will write in short like a RS cells. So Reed-Sternberg cells are neoplastic cells. They are formed by Epstein-Barr virus infection. Characteristic mirror-like nuclei, prominent nucleoli, and that is why they are also called as owl eye appearance. Here I will tell you, there was a question in AIIMS. On that basis, I just want to describe you by one statement. Are these RS cells diagnostic of Hodgkin's lymphoma? Are they diagnostic of Hodgkin's lymphoma if you see them alone? So my question is, Reed-Sternberg cells alone, is it diagnostic? Yes or no? Answer will be no, not at all. So always remember, Reed-Sternberg cell alone, they are non-diagnostic. So remember, alone, they are non-diagnostic. Why it is so? Because Reed-Sternberg cells are seen in other conditions also. So what are other conditions? So this is infectious mononucleosis. Infectious mononucleosis. So Reed-Sternberg cells can be seen in infectious mononucleosis. We can find them in non-Hodgkin's lymphomas also. We can find them in sarcomas and many other carcinomas also. So infectious mononucleosis, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, sarcoma, carcinoma, we can see Reed-Sternberg cells. So that is why RS cell alone, they are non-diagnostic. That is why alone they are non-diagnostic. Here I would like to discuss little brief about few more important questions of All India 2013 and 14. All India 2013 question was, which non-Hodgkin's lymphoma is most commonly associated with RS formation? Reed cells are most commonly seen in which non-Hodgkin's lymphoma? So remember, RS cells are most commonly seen in immunoblastic. So this was the right answer. Immunoblastic type of Reed-Sternberg cells. Sorry, immunoblastic type of NHL. So Reed-Sternberg cells are most commonly seen in immunoblastic type of non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. So this will be your right answer. So Reed-Sternberg cells in immunoblastic NHL. Previous year All India PG exam, there was a question, infectious mononucleosis. We all know that infectious mononucleosis caused by Epstein-Barr virus and their peripheral blood, they will have atypical lymphocytes. They will have atypical lymphocytes. A very old MCQ of one state exam. What is this name actually? They had used name of this atypical lymphocytes. Downy cells. Question asked was, Downy cells are seen in which condition? So remember, Downy cells are also known as atypical lymphocytes. So these atypical lymphocytes are also known as Downy cells. So these are also known as Downy cells seen in Epstein-Barr virus infection. So atypical lymphocytes are Downy cells seen in infectious mononucleosis. This was old MCQ. Previous year All India PG latest exam, they had asked question, what is this atypical lymphocyte? Is it a B cell or is it a CD4 or is it a CD8 T cell? So what is your answer? So see this. This is a very clever and smart question. Epstein-Barr virus, they will infect B cells. When they are infected by B cells, viral infected cells are killed by, this is the concept. This is the concept. Whenever virus infects a cell, who will kill them? CD8 cytotoxic cell. So whenever Epstein-Barr virus infects a B cell, as a result CD8 T cells are activated And now these CD8 T cells are called as atypical lymphocytes or Downy cells, and now this will kill this infected cell. So now question is, what is atypical lymphocyte or Downy cell in infectious mononucleosis disorder? Your answer should be CD8 cytotoxic cells. So this is the answer. So this is a very smart question. So don't think like Epstein-Barr virus is infecting B cells and they will form the atypical lymphocyte. No, not like that. Atypical lymphocytes are activated CD8 cytotoxic T cells known as Downy cells. Now they will kill this viral infected cell. So these activated CD8 T cells in peripheral blood are called as atypical lymphocyte or Downy cells. So this is about Reed-Sternberg cells. Why alone they are not diagnostic? Because they are seen in other conditions and these are other conditions. So when they will become diagnostic on histology? Reed-Sternberg cells, they will be diagnostic when they are in combination with mixed inflammation in the background. So this was the option given in AIMS exam. So always remember, Reed-Sternberg cells plus mixed inflammation in background. So mixed inflammation in background along with the Reed-Sternberg cell, this is diagnostic of Hodgkin's lymphoma. So this was a statement mentioned in AIMS exam, but it was not like this they had mentioned. Mentioning was like this, ki neoplastic cells and non-neoplastic cells combination. Neoplastic and non-neoplastic combination will confirm diagnosis of Hodgkin's lymphoma. True or false? So it's a true statement. Neoplastic is RS cell, non-neoplastic is mixed inflammation. And what are these mixed inflammatory cells? This can be a neutrophil, this can be a lymphocyte, plasma cells, it can be a histiocytes, etc. So, etc. So, these are mixed inflammation. So, mixed inflammation and RS cells, when both are present in a histological specimen, then we will say that it is a case of Hodgkin's lymphoma. Alone, they are non-diagnostic. Why they are non-diagnostic? Because Reed-Sternberg cells alone, they are seen in NHL also, most commonly immunoblastic. They can be seen in infection like infectious mononucleosis also. So that is why alone they are non-diagnostic, but in combination they are always diagnostic. So this is about Hodgkin's lymphoma diagnosis. Reed-Sternberg cell alone, Reed-Sternberg cells, they are identified by immunophenotyping. If you remember, what is immunophenotyping? Immunophenotyping. So what is immunophenotyping? Study of CD marker. So I have told you, study of CD marker, and you will remember this for a long time now, because this time we will discuss this many leukemias and lymphoma immunophenotyping. So immunophenotyping of RS cells, of Reed-Sternberg cells, is usually CD15 positive and 30 positive. 15 positive and 30 positive. But now they say that they are PAX5 also positive. So these are classical Reed-Sternberg cell, 15, 30, PAX5 positive. So if they ask CD marker, classical Reed-Sternberg cells, so these are called as classical Reed-Sternberg cells. Which is the best marker for classical Reed-Sternberg cells? So they may ask this question. Remember, I am writing order like this. Best one is PAX5, better than CD30, better than CD15. So this order we should remember. PAX5 is the best marker, CD30 after that, and after that CD15 is the best marker. So you have to choose like this. If it is given PAX5, this is the best classical Reed-Sternberg cell marker. If it is CD30, this is the second best, and the least one is CD15. So this classical Reed-Sternberg cell is a basis for classification for Hodgkin's lymphoma. How it is the basis? So according to WHO, they say that we can divide Hodgkin's lymphoma into two subtypes, classical and non-classical. So these are two subtypes we have to divide Hodgkin's lymphoma, classical and non-classical. So I'm writing here, classical Hodgkin's lymphoma and non-classical Hodgkin's lymphoma, which is also known as lymphocyte predominant Hodgkin's lymphoma. So lymphocyte predominant Hodgkin's lymphoma. So this is non-classical. So WHO, they have divided Hodgkin's lymphoma into two categories: A, classical; B, non-classical, also known as lymphocyte predominant. Classical and non-classical, what is the criteria for division? Is a CD marker, immunophenotyping is the criteria. Because classical, they were positive for classical Reed-Sternberg cell marker, 15-30 positive. Whereas non-classical, 15-30 negative. So this was All India question. These are CD15 negative, 30 negative. But they are CD20 and 45 positive. So this point we should remember. 20 positive, 45 positive. So this point we should remember. Non-classical is 20 positive, 45 positive. And this was All India question. Why there is a separation of non-classical from classical? They are CD20 positive. Number 2 point. Lymphocyte predominant, they usually arise from the germinal center of the lymph nodes. They arise from the germinal center of the lymph node. So marker of germinal center, remember, marker of germinal center is BCL6 positive. So they are BCL6 positive. So this is another new point added in New Robins. BCL6 positive. This was a question in a one state exam. Proliferative transformation of germinal center is seen in which Hodgkin's lymphoma? Answer was lymphocyte predominant. So what is this called as? Proliferative transformation of germinal center, which we write in short PTGC. So this is a line of interrope from where they have taken this question in 2011 exam. Proliferative transformation of germinal center is seen in BCL6 positive, means proliferative transformation. Why? Because they are arising from the germinal center. So PTGC is seen in lymphocyte predominant Hodgkin's lymphoma. Now, classical Reed-Sternberg cells, they are the basis for classification of classical into four subtypes. So there are four subtypes of classical Hodgkin's lymphoma. Number one is nodular sclerosis. Number two is mixed cellularity. Number three is lymphocyte poor, and number four is lymphocyte rich variant of Hodgkin's lymphoma. So these are four subtypes of classical Hodgkin's lymphoma. So now question will be, out of these five subtypes, now you can see four this one and one is lymphocyte predominant. Out of these five subtypes, which is the most common type of Hodgkin's lymphoma? So number one question, which is most common Hodgkin's lymphoma? So remember, nodular sclerosis is most common. Most common means world. So most common in world, nodular sclerosis. So nodular sclerosis is most common in world. And which is most common in India? most common in India is mixed cellularity. So remember, most common in India, or examiner can use word developing countries or developing countries. So in India or developing countries, most common is mixed cellularity. Here I want to tell you one point. They will ask you, ki which is having good prognosis, which is having bad prognosis or worse prognosis. So this good versus bad prognosis is decided by number of lymphocyte counts. If lymphocyte is more, prognosis will be good. Lymphocyte is less, prognosis will be bad. So who will have best prognosis? Lymphocyte predominant or lymphocyte rich? What to choose now? So here, when confusion arises, so we remember like this. Mnemonic is alphabets are more, so lymphocyte will be more. So alphabets are more, lymphocytes will be more. Simple. So lymphocyte predominant, more alphabet, more lymphocyte, and they will have best prognosis. So lymphocyte predominant, they have best prognosis. On the same basis, we can understand here that lymphocyte poor will be carrying worse prognosis. So this is the point we have to remember. So another important MCQ, most common in world, nodular sclerosis, India, mixed cellularity, best lymphocyte predominant, worse lymphocyte poor. As I told you, this classification is on the basis of classical Reed-Sternberg cell. So what is the name of Reed-Sternberg cell? Examiner will ask you. Nodular sclerosis, what is the name of Reed-Sternberg cell? Nodular sclerosis, Reed-Sternberg cell will be having characteristic presentation like this. Cells having bilobed nuclei or mirror-like nuclei, they will be having prominent nucleoli, but this cytoplasm, while making paraffin section, they will be removed. So cytoplasm will be clear. So here cytoplasm will be clear. Because of this clear cytoplasm, lacuna is formed. So lacuna is formed because of removal of the cytoplasm during tissue processing. Lacuna is formed. So this type of Reed-Sternberg cells are called as lacunar Reed-Sternberg cell. Lacunar Reed-Sternberg cell, one of the frequently asked MCQ. Lacunar Reed-Sternberg cells are seen in nodular sclerosis. Here examiner will ask you one question. Collagen bands are formed in which type of Hodgkin's lymphoma? Collagen bands are formed in which type of Hodgkin's lymphoma? If you remember when I was telling you about scleroderma, I told you in pathology, whenever they say sclerosis, it means collagen deposition. Sclerosis means collagen deposition. If you understood this concept, sclerosis means collagen deposition, which was previous year All India PG question also, you can see here. Nodular sclerosis is because of collagen deposition. So since collagen is deposited, and because of this collagen deposits, there is a nodule formation. So that is a nodule is formed. So that is why it is called as nodular sclerosis. So collagen is deposited in nodular sclerosis. Nodules are formed. Nodules will be containing this clear cytoplasm Reed-Sternberg cells, known as lacunar Reed-Sternberg cell. So this is our right answer. So lacunar Reed-Sternberg cells, collagen bundles are seen in nodular sclerosis, which is most common in one. Mixed cellularity, they have mixed or mononuclear type of Reed-Sternberg cell. Mononuclear type of Reed-Sternberg cells. Whereas lymphocyte poor, they have pleomorphic type of Reed-Sternberg cell. Pleomorphic Reed-Sternberg cells. But there was a question in one state exam in 2012. Mummified Reed-Sternberg cells are seen in. So remember, this pleomorphic is also known as mummified Reed Sternberg cells. Mummified Reed Sternberg cell, also known as necrobiotic Reed Sternberg cells. So these are various names for lymphocyte poor Reed Sternberg cells: pleomorphic, mummified, or necrobiotic Reed Sternberg cells. So these are various names for pleomorphic RS cells. So this mummified name had been used in one state exam previously. PGI 2011, there was a question: which of the following cells are seen in Hodgkin's lymphoma? So they had mentioned one or two of these Reed Sternberg cells, and one option was Hodgkin's cells. Do you feel Hodgkin's cells are some cells in Hodgkin's lymphoma? Do they exist? And answer is yes, they exist. Hodgkin's cells are atypical large histiocytes present in lymphocyte poor variant of Hodgkin's lymphoma. So lymphocyte poor variant, they will have Hodgkin's cells. So remember, yes, they have Hodgkin's cells. And what are these? These are atypical large histiocytes. So atypical large histiocytes are called as Hodgkin's cells. So they are seen in lymphocyte poor. So examiner can ask this question also: okay, where you will see Hodgkin's cells? Hodgkin's cells are atypical large histiocytes seen in lymphocyte poor variant of Hodgkin's lymphoma. Lymphocyte rich, they have combination of Reed Sternberg cells and they are non-specific. So there is no specific name for RS cell here. Coming to the lymphocyte predominant, as we have already discussed, they are CD20 positive. Why they have been separated? They are CD20 positive, 45 positive, BCL6 positive. But 15 and 30 is negative. 15 and 30 is positive in case of classical Hodgkin's lymphoma only. So non-classical or lymphocyte predominant, if you look at their Reed Sternberg cell, it is a characteristic appearance. And what is that appearance? See this. This is a Reed Sternberg cell of lymphocyte predominant. Their nucleus will be having many lobes. So their nucleus will be having one lobe, two lobes, and this is third lobe. So these are multilobated or polypoidal nuclei. So this description is given like this: multilobated or polypoidal nuclei are seen in lymphocyte predominant, and this appearance looks like a popcorn kernel. Looks like a popcorn. So that is why a specific name is given to this lymphocyte predominant Reed Sternberg cells, multilobated polypoidal nuclei known as popcorn cell. So this is called as popcorn Reed Sternberg cell. So we all know that. So their nickname is popcorn Reed Sternberg cell. Examiner here ask you, what is popcorn Reed Sternberg cell actually known as? What is the actual name of this popcorn cell? So your answer should be, they are also known as lymphocyte histiocyte rich variant of Reed Sternberg cells. Rich variant of Reed Sternberg cells. So this is the popcorn cell. Lymphocyte histiocyte rich variant of Reed Sternberg cell is a popcorn cell. So this is the point we have to remember. So this is a brief outline for Hodgkin's lymphoma. Here, as you remember in the beginning of the discussion, I told you Epstein-Barr virus, they are usually responsible, not always. So this is the question: which is not associated out of these five subtypes of Hodgkin's lymphoma? Five subtypes, four classical, one non-classical. Out of these five subtypes, which is not associated with Epstein-Barr virus infection. So remember, first one nodular sclerosis, last one lymphocyte predominant. So nodular sclerosis and lymphocyte predominant is not associated with Epstein-Barr virus infection. So here we will remember like this. Epstein-Barr virus infection is not associated with nodular sclerosis, number one, and number two is lymphocyte predominant type of Hodgkin's lymphoma. So these are two which is not associated. Here examiner will ask you ki then which is most commonly associated with Epstein-Barr virus, most commonly associated with Epstein-Barr virus infection. So your answer should be mixed cellularity. Mixed cellularity is most commonly associated with Epstein-Barr virus infection. PGL exam did ask this question: what are the Hodgkin's lymphomas associated with HIV? So see, this Epstein-Barr virus infection, they are most commonly with mixed cellularity. So same thing, most commonly associated with HIV virus infection, HIV infection. Then what will be your answer? Most commonly associated with HIV infection. I know that you might be thinking about lymphocyte poor, which is mentioned in Robbins, which is not a right statement or right answer. This is a right answer from Wintrobe. HIV infection, they are most commonly associated with, again, mixed cellularity. So make a note of this point. HIV infection is most commonly associated with mixed cellularity. So this should be right answer. So number one, mixed cellularity. Number two, this was PGI question. They are after that associated with lymphocyte poor, and third one is nodular sclerosis. So these are Hodgkin's lymphoma associated with HIV. Here when I was going through Wintrobe line where it was written, I found one line which I feel it's a very interesting and could be your MCQ, because in Harrison also they had mentioned a line similar to it. Question will be like this. I am giving you one statement. Statement is, HIV defining lymphomas are Hodgkin's lymphomas. True or false? True or false? And it's a false statement. Remember, HIV infection defining lymphomas are only non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. So always remember, Hodgkin's lymphoma, they are not defining HIV infection. So HIV infection defining lymphoma. So remember, HIV infection defining lymphomas are non-Hodgkin's lymphoma only. So only non-Hodgkin's lymphomas are HIV defining lymphoma. It is never Hodgkin's lymphoma. So this point we should remember for our exam. So here examiner will ask you, they had asked earlier in All India PG exam and previous year also, which non-Hodgkin's lymphoma is more commonly associated with HIV? Which non-Hodgkin's lymphoma is most commonly associated with HIV? And if you think about primary CNS lymphoma, that is a wrong answer. This is a line of Harrison. Line of Harrison, 18th edition. Which non-Hodgkin's lymphoma is most commonly associated? So remember, they are most commonly associated with immunoblastic type of non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, which is present in 60% of HIV patient. Whereas primary CNS lymphoma, they are associated with 20% of HIV patient. So that is why I said, when examiner asks you ki which non-Hodgkin's lymphoma is most commonly associated with HIV infection, your answer should be immunoblastic 60%, because primary CNS lymphoma is just seen in 20%. So again, what I am showing you now is a language part of the question. When it will be the right answer? when examiner says like this, which is most common, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma of brain in HIV patient. So remember, when examiner says which is most common NHL in brain of HIV patient, of HIV positive patient, then your answer should be primary CNS lymphoma. So be careful, most common NHL in HIV positive brain will be primary CNS, but when they ask about overall which is the most common type of NHL in HIV patient, then your answer should be immunoblastic lymphoma seen in 60% of HIV patient. So this is the point just wanted to discuss you. So here what I want to tell you, HIV infection in Hodgkin's lymphoma, first of all, they are non-defining lymphomas for HIV infection. Number two, most common is mixed cellularity. And there are other two, lymphocyte poor and nodular sclerosis. So these three were options mentioned in PGI exam 2010. So this is how I have told you about Hodgkin's lymphoma. So now I will show you some exam oriented pictures, diagrams. Okay, let's wait for this. So before I will tell you, I will just brief you about leukemia. So now we will start NHL or leukemias.